Hello friends and welcome back on my channel. My name is Alex and in this video I'm gonna show you how to make this exercise, this assembly in SolidWorks. And for this we'll be following the next sketch. So here we have the sketch with all the components. First we'll start with this base. Then we'll make the pulley, the washer, the spring washer, the rod and the next parts. So let's start. Now we'll have to open a new part. And here we'll open a sketch in the top plane. And now we'll make the next sketch. We'll select line. And make a sketch just like this. Okay, now select this line and this line, select here, make equal, select all these four, and select here, make equal, and then select these two, and select, and make them equal, equal, okay, now select this point, and select here, make vertical, and do the same with these two. Nice. Now select this one and select here make horizontal. Good. Now we'll have to select smart dimension command and we'll have to define this sketch. So from this line to this line, here will be 80 millimeters. Okay. From this point to this point, here will be 40 millimeters. This line here will have 56 millimeters. And now we'll have to make a center line, just like this. And with smart dimension, we'll give here an angle, and this angle will have 60 degrees. Perfect. Now I have to make four holes. Just like this. Now we'll make another center line. Okay, and with smart dimension we'll dimension these holes, these circles. We'll have the diameter 5 millimeters. Make them equal from this center point to this center point. Here will be 40 millimeters, and from this circle to this middle point, here will be 20 millimeters, and from this circle to this center line. Here will be 32 millimeters. And now we have to select this center point and this center point and make them horizontal. Nice. Now we have to use mirror entities command and we select these two circles. And at mirror about we select this center line. And press OK. And now we have four circles. OK. Now we have to make another circle here, just like this, and another center line in the middle of this line. And now we have to dimension this from this center point to this line. Here will be 22 millimeters. This circle will have the diameter 12 millimeters. And now we have to select line and we'll make two lines starting from this line and will be tangent to this circle and horizontal. And another one and horizontal. Okay, now we can use trim entities command and we can cut these lines because we don't need them. Okay, now make these two equal and this is fully defined. Now we have to mirror this on this other side. So select mirror entities command, select these two lines and this arc, and at mirror above select this center line, press OK. And now with trim entities command we'll cut this part also. Now this is fully defined, we'll just go to features and actually we can use sketch fillet here or we can use fillet later. I think we'll use fillet later. So select extruded boss base and here the thickness will be 12 millimeters and press OK. Now let's make this plain white. Now we'll open a sketch on this face, normal too, and here we'll have to make a rectangle just like this, make this vertical, and now let's make a center line because we'll have to mirror this rectangle on this other side. And with smart dimension we'll give here a dimension. This line here will have 26 millimeters. And now select mirror entities command and select this rectangle and at mirror about this center line. Press OK. Now we'll go to features and we'll use extruded cut. And here the depth will be 3 millimeters. Press OK. Nice. Now we'll just have to use fillet command, so select fillet and here the radius will be 10 millimeters and select these edges . Okay, press OK and now the base is done. We'll have to save it. I'm gonna save it on my desktop. Phase 1. Okay, now we have to make the next part, which will be the pulley. So go to file, actually go here to new and open a new part. Here we'll select front plane and we'll open sketch. And now we'll select center line and we'll make here a center line. And now we'll have to select line and we'll make the next sketch. Just like this. And now we'll have to define this. So we'll select first, let's make these two lines equal, these two also equal, these two also equal, and it's okay. Let's select smart dimension and we'll give here some dimensions. This here we have 4 millimeters. Okay. From this line to the center line, here will be 12 millimeters. From this line to the center line, here will be 10. Actually, just a second. Here will be 6 millimeters, and here will be 10. Okay. And this line here will have 22 millimeters. Nice. From this line to this line, here will be 6. This line here will have 26. and from this line to the center line, here will be 22 millimeters. And now this is fully defined. We'll go to features and we'll use revolve and boss base. And this center line should be selected. Press OK. Nice, the pulley is almost done. We'll just have to use fillet. So select fillet. Here the radius will be 2. Select these two edges and on this other side. Press OK. And now we have to save it too. So this is. And I'm gonna save it on my desktop also. And now we have to make the next part. So open a new part. Save it and open a new part. Okay. And here open a sketch in the front plane. And now we'll make a circle. Now we are making the road. So with smart dimension we'll give this a diameter, will be 8 millimeters. And now go to features, use extruded boss base, and here the dimension will be 60 millimeters. Press OK. Now we'll have to use fillet for these two edges, and here the radius will be 6. Actually the radius should be 2. Okay, and press here OK. Nice. And now we'll have to open a sketch in the front plane. Actually not front plane, right plane. Normal tool. And here we'll have to make a center line first in the middle of this edge. And then outline, we'll make the next sketch. Make a small rectangle just like this, and then with smart dimension we need a dimension here will be 1 millimeters from this line to this edge. Here will be 3 millimeters, and from this line to this center point here will be 3 millimeters. Okay, now we'll have to use mirror and we'll select this rectangle and that mirror about this center line. Press here OK, and now we have to make another center line starting from this center point. And now go to features and use revolved cut, and we have to select this center line. Press OK. This is perfect. Now we have to save it. I'll save it on my desktop. Okay, and now we'll have to make the spring washer, which will be coming into this slot here. Open a new part, and now we'll open a sketch in the front plane, and here we'll make two circles. Just like this, and with smart dimension we'll dimension them. This one will have the diameter of 16 millimeters, and this one will have the diameter of 6 millimeters. Nice. Now we'll select line, and we'll make a line from this circle to this circle. And now we'll select center line. And we'll just make here two center lines like this. And now we'll use mirror entities command to mirror this and mirror above this center line. Press here OK. And now from this point to this point, here will be 3.5 millimeters. I think should be 4 millimeters. Okay, and now we'll use mirror entities command again and This time we'll select these two lines and that mirror about this center line. Press it OK. And now with trim entities command we cut this part of the circle and this part. And now we'll select line and we'll make here the next two lines just like this. And now it's my dimension. We have to dimension this. This right here will have 1.5 millimeters. Okay, now with trim entities we can cut this part and then we'll give here a dimension. This will have 3 millimeters. And now we'll have to use mirror entities command to mirror these two lines and that mirror about this center line. Press here OK. And then with trim entities command cut this part. Okay, then select these two points and select here make vertical. And then select this line and this line and select here make aligner. Perfect, now with trim entities command we'll cut these parts of the circle. Okay. And now we'll go to features and we'll use extruded boss base. And here will be one. The thickness will be 1 millimeter. Press OK. And now this is done. We have to save it like all the other parts. Okay. And now we have to make the next part. So open a new part. And here we'll open a sketch in the front plane. Now we'll be making this part. Okay. And now select a center line. Where to make a center line here. Then with line we'll make the next sketch. Just like this. And now we'll have to define this with smart dimension. This line here will have 22 millimeters. This one here will have 3 millimeters. From this line to this center line here will be 6 millimeters. From this line to the center line here will be 4 millimeters, and from this line to the center line here will be 7. And now this is fully defined. Now we just go to features, use revolved boss base and press OK. Very easy. Now we just have to save it. So I will save it on my desktop. Okay. And now I'll have to make the next part, which will be a washer. Open a sketch in the front plane and here we'll make two circles. Just like this. This one will have 16 millimeters in diameter and this one will have 8. Now go to features and use extruded boss base and the thickness will be 3 millimeters. Press here OK and now just save it. Press OK and now I have to make the next and the last part, which will be the support. Let me show you. We make this part, but for this part will not be making these two holes because I cannot figure out the dimension, the position for them, and we'll be making this when we're gonna assembly all of them, because we'll have to assemble them first and then we'll take these two holes as references and we'll make this other two. So let's do this. So save it and open any part. And here we'll open a sketch in the top plane first. I'll make a rectangle, center rectangle, and this will have the next dimensions. This line here will have 26, and this one here will have 56. These dimensions, you can see them in the base, at the base sketch, because here will be the support fitting, so 26 per 56. Okay, now just go to features and use extruded boss base. Here the thickness will be 8 millimeters. Press OK. And now let's make this plane white and open a sketch on this face, normal tool. Here first we'll make two circles. Just like this, and with smart dimension we'll dimension them. This one will have 8 millimeters in diameter, and this one will have 34 millimeters. Okay, and now we'll have to select point and we'll place here a point in this point. This is just for reference, and now with smart dimension we'll select this point and this center point, and here the dimension will be 45 millimeters. And now we'll select line and we'll make here a line, which we'll make just like this. Select this line in this circle and select here make tangent, and here is already tangent, but to be sure, select again. And now select this center point and this center point and select here make vertical. Now with trim and tilt command we'll cut this part of the circle. Perfect. Now go to features and use extruded boss base command. Select here reverse direction, and here the thickness will be also 8 millimeters. Press OK. Nice. Now we'll have to save it. Okay, and now we'll have to start the assembly. We have here these screws, but we'll import them from the library when we'll do the assembly. Let's go back to base, because this is the part which I want to be fixed. And let's go here to file and make assembly from part. One click to place it. Then go first, let's make this plain white. Then go here to insert components and select all of the parts you just made for this assembly. With control pressed, select all of them. And then just one click for each of them to place it. Okay, so you must have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 parts. And now I'll have to start the assembly. First I'm gonna assemble this support here, and I will make another one, and I will make the holes, and then I'm gonna assemble the rest of the parts. So let's start. Select this face and select here coincide, then select this face with this face and select here coincide. And then the last one, select this face with this face and select here coincide. Nice. Now with control pressed, left click and drag it, and then you will have two. Okay, now use rotate component from move component to rotate this to be easier to mate it. Okay, and now we have to do the same thing. Select this face, with this face, and select here coincide, then this face with this one, so these two coincide, and then this one with this one and coincide. Perfect. Now we'll have to make the holes for the screw. So to do this, we'll just go here to assembly features, and from here we'll select simple hole. I'll select this, and then first I will select this. I will select the face inside this hole, and here the diameter will be 5 millimeters. Just press OK for now, and then we'll go back to hole 1, click on this arrow, select sketch 1, select here edit sketch, and now we'll edit this. So first we'll select this circle and this edge, and we'll select here concentric, and that's it. And now we'll have to make a center line in the middle of this edge. This center line, actually it's an easier way, just select convert entities command and convert this edge, press here OK, and then just exit the sketch. Nice. Let's see if it's working and for this side. So go back to sketch 1, edit sketch, select convert entities command. I think it's not gonna work, but we'll see. So convert this edge, convert in this one, and exit. Yeah, it's not working because we placed, because this sketch is made on the face of this part, and this is another part, and that's why it's not working. But we can place another hole. So go to assembly features, select simple hole, and select that face inside the hole. Just press here OK, and then we'll go back to hole 2, open the sketch, and here select this circle and this edge, and select here concentric. Nice. And now convert entities, convert this edge, press OK, and now just exit the sketch. And now that we have all the holes, we'll have to assemble all of these other parts. So we have to rotate these two first. So go to move component, select rotate component, rotate this one like this, and this one like this. This is OK. And now we'll just select this face with, actually it's this face with this face first, select here concentric, select this face and this face, and select here coincide. This is good. Select then this face with this face, select here concentric. Nice. Now select this face with this face, and select here concentric, and then select this face. With this edge, and select here concentric. Okay. And now select this face and this face, and select here coincide, Nice. Now just move this inside here, this one also. Okay. And now we have to make this road to stay fixed here. So for this I will select this face and this face, and I will select up here mate, and here I will select dimension and I will put here 10 millimeters. Press OK, and now this is equal, the dimension is equal on both sides and it's not moving anywhere. Now I have to do the same thing for this pulley. So I will select this face with this face, I will select here dimension and here 1 millimeter. Press here OK, and now this is also equal spacing on both sides, 1 millimeter, 1 millimeter. Press here OK, and now this is not going anywhere, it's just rotating. It's the same with this rod. And now I have to put these spring washers. Select this face from the side and this face from here, and select concentric, and then select this face with this face and select coincide, mate and coincide. Now we'll have to make one more of those, and to do this we'll just have to keep control pressed, select and drag it, and let's do the same thing for this one. So this face with this face, concentric, then this one with this one, coincide. Perfect. Now this assembly is almost done, we'll just have to import the screws and to place them here. So I will just select, so to import screws go here to design library and open toolbox, select here add in now, and then go to ISO, go to bolts and screws, and I think I will select no this one, yeah I will select this one, okay, and here we'll select M5 and the length will be 16. Perfect. Press here OK, and then just go near the hole and the bolt should snap into the hole just like this, and just click to place it. Okay, perfect. Now we'll have to delete this extra one. Deleted, yes. And now this assembly is done, this video is done, and if you like it you can subscribe to see more, you can leave a like, you can leave a comment with your opinion or any advices if you have. Thank you, and I hope to see you in the next video. See you there.